a reading from the book of Esther. On the third day, Esther put on her royal robes and stood in the inner court of the king's palace, opposite the king's hall. The king was sitting on his royal throne inside the palace, opposite the entrance to the palace. As soon as the king saw Queen Esther standing in the court, she won his favor and he held out to her the golden scepter that was in his hand. Then Esther approached and touched the top of the scepter. The king said to her, "What is it, Queen Esther? What is your request? It shall be given you, even to the half of my kingdom." Then Esther said, "If it pleases the king, let the king and Haman come today to a banquet that I have prepared for the king." Then the king said, "Bring Haman quickly, so that we may do as Esther desires." So the king and Haman came to the banquet that Esther had prepared. While they were drinking wine, the king said to Esther, "What is your petition? It shall be granted you. And what is your request? Even to the half of my kingdom, it shall be fulfilled." Then Esther said, "This is my petition and request, that if I have won the king's favor, and if it pleases the king to grant my petition and fulfill my request, let the king and Haman come tomorrow to the banquet that I will prepare for them, and then I will do as the king has said." Haman went out that day happy and in good spirits. But when Haman saw Mordecai in the king's gate and observed that he neither rose nor trembled before him, he was infuriated with Mordecai. Nevertheless, Haman restrained himself and went home. Then he sent and called for his friends and his wife Zeresh, and Haman recounted to them the splendor of his riches, the number of his sons, all the promotions with which the king had honored him, and how he had advanced him above the officials and the ministers of the king. Haman added, "Even Queen Esther let no one but myself come with the king to the banquet that she prepared. Tomorrow also I am invited by her together with the king. Yet all this does me no good so long as I see the Jew Mordecai sitting at the king's gate." Then his wife Zeresh and all his friends said to him, "Let a gallows 50 cubits high be made, and in the morning tell the king to have Mordecai hanged on it. Then go with the king to the banquet in good spirits." This advice pleased Haman, and he had the gallows made. Here ends the first reading.
Thank you.
A reading from the book of Revelation. To the angel of the church of Ephesus, write, these are the words of him who holds the seven stars in his right hand, who walks among the seven golden lampstands. I know your works, your toil, and your patient endurance. I know that you cannot tolerate evildoers. You have tested those who claim to be apostles, but are not, and have found them to be false. I also know that you are enduring patiently and bearing up for the sake of my name, and that you have not grown weary. But I have this against you, that you have abandoned the love you had at first. Remember then from what you have fallen, repent, and do the works you did at first. If not, I will come to you and remove your lampstand from its place, unless you repent. Yet this is to your credit. You hate the works of Nicolaitans, which I also hate. Let anyone who has an ear listen to what the Spirit is saying to the churches. To everyone who conquers, I will give permission to eat from the tree of life that is the paradise of God. Here ends the second reading.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty.
Let us pray. Show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy spirit.
O Lord, save the Queen.
And mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endure thy ministers with righteousness.
And make thy chosen people to joyful.
O Lord, save thy people. Beseech thee to keep thy household, the church, in continual godliness, that through thy protection it may be free from all adversities and devoutly given to serve thee in good works to the glory of thy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray. We pray for our Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, asking for recovery of physical health. Spiritually, may she be alert to your speaking to her at this late season of life. Console her. Bless her. And bless all set in authority under her, that they may order all things in wisdom, righteousness, and peace, to the honor of your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We pray for your church, inspired by the example of your servant Richard Hooker. Help your people avoid the excess of extremism, the dead end of dogmatism. Give to Christians clarity where your word is obvious. But where there is ambiguity, give the church the good sense to draw upon the wisdom of tradition and the insights of human rationality. God of unchangeable power and eternal light, look favorably upon the mystery of a human people called the Church. By your providence, fill us with divine light, that all things may return to magnificence through him by whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We pray for writers, journalists, poets, pundits, and so-called thought leaders. Just as your servant Richard saw that a middle way was a goodly way, give to us irenic voices, pedagogues of peace. In a culture of either or, may our public intellectuals see the wholeness of a threefold cord. In the valley of naming and shaming, grant them humility to consider that light may indeed be shining in the lives of those deemed dim. Whatsoever words are true, whatsoever words are honorable, whatsoever words are just, whatsoever words are pure, whatsoever words are lovely, whatsoever words are of good report, draw us to these words, through Jesus, divine word in human flesh. Amen. And finally, with all Australians, we give thanks for the safe recovery of little Cleo. Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and dost promise that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their request. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants, as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen. In the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost, be with us all evermore. Amen.
peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.